Philippine shares tumbled hard last Friday as investors reacted to the Philippine Central Bank's off-cycle rate hike of 25 basis points, while signaling further tightening could be ahead to tame inflation, currently at 6.1% for September, back to the 2-4% target range. The PSE index fell nearly 1% on Friday to close at 59.61, notching a 3% weekly loss. Joining us now for a market preview in this very short trading week, just 2 days of trade, is BDO Capital's Ed Francisco. Hi, Ed. Thank you so much for joining us on this holiday.
Good morning, Mimi.
Good morning. So I want to start with the big story today. First of all, how important are barangay and SK elections and the results to the business and investing community?
Yeah, no, it's very important. Admittedly, we don't know much of the candidates. It would be nice if there was more information. But imagine for the young kids themselves, it's a chance for them to govern. So for those who are running, it's a chance for you to learn, to prove that you can lead. And then you can also hopefully have good corporate governance and be transparent and accountable. For also those voting, the 18 to 30, this is your right to vote also. So please exercise it and choose wisely. It's very important. And for us, the older generation, we want to see this happening because these are the keys anyway. These are the people on the ground. So if our barangays and our SKs are not doing well, then it will show itself in the LGU and even in the national and national level.
And so they can, having a lineup of inefficient and dishonest officials can make, running businesses very hard, even starting them up, and discourage investors, right?
Yes.
All right. So Ed, let's shift gears now to the main topic at hand, the aggressive rate hiking cycle by the Banco Central. Do you think, has that pressured the traditional 60-40 portfolio and made that strategy a loss-making one, or are you still a big believer of 60-40?
It's actually just supported, in fact, our recommendations to be long on cash and fixed income, right? What it just means, though, it will take longer for your equities to, to recover and do better. I'm still a believer that the equities will outperform, except it just delays it, right? As you mentioned, there might be another increase, and then we're hoping that the Fed and even the BSP start, leveling rates and decreasing rates first half next year.
So how long? How long is the delay, Ed? How patient do we need to be?
baka sayang nga, the U.S. might even go ahead because diba, they reported the 4.9% GDP growth. Mm-hmm. And here we are with very high inflation yet. But ideally, we wanted to be better performing. We still will perform relatively good, one of the fastest. But then if our inflation is not yet tamed in this next report, then I think the Governor Ellie will be forced to have another increase. I hope not, but the key really is inflation. And then, of course, the economy is slowing down a bit as planned because they want inflation to go down. Loan growth has slowed down. We're already seeing that. It's still growing, but it's slower. Mm-hmm. And then we're seeing already, even my wife is complaining about the high cost of the groceries.
But I'm sure you won't have any problem with the Noche Buena, Ed, not Ed Francisco. But I wonder, Ed, what did we miss? What did we get wrong? Because I remember at the start of this year, everybody was saying, we're such a bright spot. The macro numbers are so strong. Inflation's starting to ease. At least it looks like it a few months ago. And what's keeping us down was really just sentiment from outside, things we could not control. But now we're starting to hear, wow, there's so many cracks in our local economy. What did we miss? Did we miss anything, you think?
Not necessarily miss, but you're right. I mean, things that were more within our control. For example, we're very import dependent for fuel. That's really hard, right? Mm. So that's something that we could not control. But then on the other hand, rice. I think rice and the basic commodities, we could have done better. Right, the planning of the importations, the supporting of the farmers, and then of course expectations were set for the 20 pesos per kilo rice. Mm-hmm. I still believe in this government, but sana nga that was implemented better and there was stock. There was stock because that's the biggest hit. The people are feeling the pinch really. because the food and of course fuel are the biggest factors in our CPI. If that was better controlled, then it would be better. It would be easier for the Filipinos, especially in the lower classes. But in terms of the rollout, I'm just hoping that there'll be more rollout of the PPPs because they're on the right track. The economic team is very good anyway. Mm-hmm. We just want to see more activity so that there'll be more investors. Because the investors are interested, the long term. Of course, the short term investors, there's a flight out as you showed in your numbers from the PSE. But long term investors, they're here to invest in infrastructure, energy. They're looking for deals talaga. There are just not too many deals that being launched or being bidded out by the PPP Center, for example. So we just hope that can be accelerated because there's interest.
All right. Let's take a look at the calendar that we have for this week. And it's just two trading days for local investors. All eyes will be on the Fed interest rate decision. You've got labor market report, followed by ISM manufacturing and services PMI. The Bank of England's also going to come out with the rate decision. The Fed, the Bank of Japan will be first. That's tomorrow, Tuesday. For the Philippines, we're just waiting on the local front for S&P Global Manufacturing PMI to see how our factory output is doing. But anything to move the needle this week, or is it going to be, you know, more of the same?
Yeah, for this week, I think more of the same. The key decision was made already last week by the BSP, right? And then anyway, as you know, because it was a long weekend, people already unloaded on their stocks last Friday. And that's why the index fell. And then because it's a short week, I don't anticipate people to go gangbusters and invest. They, to be conservative, you know, the market activity will restart next Monday. That way, at least, you know, they are not going to be surprised by the long weekend if there's going to be problems with Gaza or, as you said, other global news. So very quiet week, just good time to pray, be with your loved ones, remember them, and ask for guidance from up there.
Well said, Ed. I wanted to ask you, what is your annual outlook for stocks in the next 3 years? You said you have to be patient to see good returns from your equities or your stock positions. I mean, are you looking at a certain number over the next 3 years? And my next question is, whether you think fund flows is more important as a driver for share prices than EPS growth? Which one's heavier now, EPS growth or fund flows?
Okay. The first question is the next 3 years. Anyway, historically, stocks have always performed higher than the fixed income, right? Mm-hmm. So even if today, let's say the 7-10 year government yields at around 6%, generally stocks have been trading, the average stocks returns have been trading maybe 3-5% above that. Mm-hmm. So even if the rates stay elevated, but as they normalize, you should look at maybe 9-10% growth in the stock. And remember, it's gone down already from historical highs. So para lang bumawi where it was before, that's probably already a 10-15% growth annually. But maybe conservative, even 9-10% should be great as long as things normalize. That's the next 3 years, no? Okay. And I think that's already very conservative. Your second question, funds flow
versus EPS growth.
I think, versus EPS, no? Because diba, our EPS growth numbers have been good naman. We've been showing good numbers. But then, because it's sometimes macro, the investors, despite their good EPS, are still have not come back in the foreign at least, no? So you're right, it's more funds flow. We really have to, you know, court them, get them to go back in. I think that's the key. Because when we go on road shows, let's say the SM Group, BDO Group, right? We go out, a lot of them are already positioning, but they haven't made the final decision. So we need more of the, especially the high level, and that's why the government road shows are very important, because we're selling the country. We have to sell them on the long-term growth of this country.
Because I was seeing some interesting data online, Ed, about average value turnover in $1 million. Vietnam is now at number two. We're actually last. So we really need to ramp up interest, you know, in the Philippine markets, right?
Sad. No, we were the first index, and then now we're the last. So even in my Map Viber group, so it's very sad. But we have to do something about it. But then also on the other hand, Mimi, the stock market index is very important, but it's not the real indicator of activity, right? Again, because we have so much of this, the other economy, right? The underground economy, mm-hmm. but at least when they've been performing well, it's not showing. And that's why, in a way, diba, even if the PSE index has been down, loan growth has been good, okay. has been growing. So that's a sign that there's really growth in the economy because we're seeing, we're seeing our traders, mm-hmm. we're seeing our various capitalists still needing money for their inventories and for their pickups.
All right, Ed, I just have one interesting corporate story I wanted to ask you about. Dennis Oi, last week he entered into a deal with Metrobank and a private school retirees group for some sort of debt restructuring. How are you viewing the Dennis Oi empire today? It used to be the darling. He was a friend of the president then. And now you're starting to hear a lot of his companies unloading, divesting. Phoenix Petroleum Philippines, divesting the Singapore unit, for example. And in this one, he's entering into restructuring agreements with banks and groups.
Right. Yeah. No, anyway, restructuring is needed because I guess his cash flows have weakened. Because of COVID, it really hit them. And then I guess he's tried to raise capital, but it was, of course, strained. Mm-hmm. But the effort is there. So selling various businesses, various brands has always been in part of the playbook. We've been working with Dennis Oi and his president, Marty Escalona, for the longest time, exploring different avenues from selling the food, selling the schools, parts of Phoenix, even some of their land. So that's ongoing. The objective there really is to, I guess, help some of the companies so that they can get on a better footing. And then whatever can be sold will be sold as long as it's not sobrang palugi. So that, I think that will continue. And that's good because we don't want anyway a banking crisis, and that shouldn't happen. The total exposure to his group is not that big that it will cause a problem. The banking industry is very strong, and besides that's very negative already. We think these things will work out, and even with Dito, right? Yet that the loans were restructured, so it's moving, naman.
All right, fair enough. I think we're ready for your blind item. The stock that you like, talk to us about this stock. Don't tell us. Just describe, really, leave reviewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us today?
Okay. Again, I won't reveal who it is, but again, because there's been so many challenges, especially on inflation and everything. So this one is a personal favorite of mine. They're hoping to have another factory or another branch. I'm not using the correct term, but it's intentionally to confuse the viewers. Okay. Hopefully in a year. And then there was also some reorganization of their shares. They tried to bring in increase the float and shareholders, but I think it's all for good stead. But in terms of their sales, the revenue, I'm hearing very, very strong numbers. Lots of users, lots of people coming in to use their products. So I'm very bullish on it.
All right. What sort of upside in share price?
Given where they are, I think maybe 30 to 40% is very doable by year end.
30 to 40% by year end. We're going to have to guess which stock this is.
Oh, sorry. Year end, and maybe the next 6 months. Year end, but it's 2 months now. No, maybe 6 months.
Still good. 30, 40% in 6 months. We're going to guess which stock this is, Ed. Thank you so much for the time and for the insights this morning. Always a pleasure speaking with you. Good to see you.
Bye-bye, Mimi. Thank you.
All right.